Hi guys, this is Self-Reason. You are welcome. In this lesson, we'll be looking at drainage. Okay, we'll be doing something like this, the modeling. Okay, so if you have not subscribed, you do so and stay tuned. Okay, and so we will be creating a new project now. So I click on new. In the new project, I will change this name, okay, to drain, just like this, and I'll click on okay. UK BS810, I import, okay. Alright, so we will be placing grids, okay? So I will click on orthogonal axis generator, okay? And then click on the drawing board. Alright, so what we'll be having here on this this dialog, this axis spacing will be having here to be 500 comma, okay? And then we'll have this place to be 1000, okay? Then this place will do comma again, another 1000, okay, sorry, 500. All right so this 500 is the tapered site, okay. This other 500 is also this other tapered site, okay, while this 1000 here is the width of the drain, okay. So the length of the drain, we are considering 20 meter length of drain, okay. So what we need to do is we will place at first 6000, okay, and then we'll add comma, okay. We have 1200, okay, just like this, and we'll have also comma again, and we will still have another let's say 7000, okay. We'll do comma again, and then we'll have 1200 again, then we'll do comma again, then the next one, because we are considering 20 meter, and so if you are considering 20 meter, we will be adding 6000 plus 1200, we have 7200 plus 7000, you have 14200 plus 1200, we'll be having a 15,400, and so we'll be having left here will be 4,600. So we'll be having 4,600. So if you sum all of this together, gives you the length of this drain, okay. This plus this plus this plus this plus this, sum them, give you the length of the drain. We are having this 1.2 here and 1.2 here at the spacing between the two manhole, okay. All right, so I will now click on okay. So you now have something like this. This is exactly what we expected to have, okay. So we want to start by inserting our wall, okay. But by then we will go to building set out, and then we will go to insert story. Okay, we'll be having kind of a two-story, just like this. Alright, so let's just cancel this for now. Right, let us insert our wall. We'll do that later, okay? So, we will be having a wall of 100, okay? 100 thickness of wall, okay? But we will first go by 250, okay? So you click this point and you click this other point, just like this, okay? Then you click this particular button and then select this, okay, just like this, then click on update. You have something like this, okay? It's all right. And so you do the same thing here. You click on this point and then you click on this point, just like this, okay? And then click on this button line, select this, all right, and then click on update. You have something like this. Alright, so mind you, we are on level 1, okay? So after you must have inserted this, the next thing you have to do is to close this just like this. Alright, so after you close this, we'll be inserting this slab, okay? The top, the slab that will be on top of the drainage, okay? So we click on the slab. In this case, the thickness of our slab will be using 100, just like this, okay? And the cover is 25, okay? So we want to insert this using, using insertion point, okay? So we will select pick axis just like this. So I will pick this axis, okay? And I will, after picking that axis, I will pick this one, this axis. Then I will pick this one, I will pick this one, and finally I will pick this one just like this to insert the slab, okay? So I will delete all axes and click on the close button. Alright, just like this. And so the next thing we need to do is we'll have to navigate to story zero. Okay, this story zero. You double click here, you have this. So we want to put base of the drain, okay? Yeah, okay. So we'll click on the slab, okay, just like this. With this same thickness, okay, we want to use a insertion point too. Don't lost just like this. So we click this grid line one. We click this grid line B. Okay, we click grid line 6. Then you select grid line C. And finally, you select grid line 1 again to insert it. So just like this, okay. Alright, so after which you delete all the axes and then click on update and closed. Okay, so far the next thing we have to do is we will go to building setout. Okay, in the building setout, we edit stories. Alright, so we are only having one story here. Okay, since we're having one story here, this story we want to make it 2 meters. Alright, so this 2 meters is considered to be the height of the drain, okay? Alright, so our foundation in this case we are going to use 200. No, I will reduce to 150, okay? To be a foundation depth, okay? So after which click on okay. You say yes, okay? Alright, so we'll also navigate, okay? Let's navigate to the 3D to see what we have done so far. So you have something like this. Alright, so you can see this is the trapezoidal drain. So we want to select this, hold the control key, select this one, okay, right click. Alright, so just navigate to the story one before you do that. Take the grid to the story one, okay, which is level one. Alright, then hold this, right click, and then select a property. In this property dialog, select this, open this editor, and then change the thickness of the drain to 100. Just like this. See, it has changed here. And then you closed it. Just like this. Okay. Alright, so the next thing we are going to do, you can see this is the drain. Okay. The next thing we are going to do, you go to the plan view. Just like this. We are going to create an opening here. This opening will serve as a manhole, okay, for the drain, okay, this one, okay. Alright, so for us to do that, we will use this slab opening drop. You click on it. Alright, once you click on it, you just have to select this point and then you select this point. You have an opening, okay. You do the same thing here. Click here and then enter 0, click place 0, and then you click this point and you click this point. You have an opening. Click on update and then you close this. Okay, all right so we can now navigate to the 3D again, just like this, and you have an opening here on the drain. All right so this is the drain. Okay, so the next thing we need to add a cover to this. we have cover to the manhole. The manhole we need to have cover. So for us to do that, we'll go to building, set out, click on the insert story. So we have already have a story one, so next thing we need to have a story two, just like this. You click on OK, so you have story two of this height. So you go to edit story, just like this, to edit the story. So you come to story two, and we'll be having the height to be 100, just like this. Okay, have the height to be 100, you click on OK. So you're having something like this. So you navigate to that story too, then go to the plan view of it. Okay, go to the plan view of it. We'll be placing a slab here, okay, and this place. Okay, and so we click on the slab, okay, just like this. Once you click on the slab, click on slab. So you go to the instruction, okay, you move from this peak axis to axis region, just like this, and then you can be able to place a slab here and then place a slab here. So this is the only places we needed to place slabs, okay. So after which you click on the closed, okay. Alright, so you now view it in 3D. Now by then we have to save the project. Alright, so after saving the project, you navigate to the 3D. Just like this. So you will be having something like this. So this one, this is your drain, okay? And then this is the cover to the drain openings, okay? Like the manholes, okay? Alright, so this is how to model a drain, okay? Using a protact structure. Alright? So if this lesson of help you in one way or the other, do it to subscribe, like the video, okay, and stay tuned for more advanced lesson of this kind. Subsequently we'll run analysis on this drain and they will be able to get what we want, including the calculation sheet of the rebars, okay. So stay tuned, okay, as I'll bring to you another advanced lessons. Okay, bye for now.